you, Jesus. Lord, we bless your name, God. We will bless the Lord, oh my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Hallelujah, Jesus. We bless you, God, and magnify you, Lord. Come on, church, let's lift him up, for he is good. Hallelujah. This is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. Lord, we bless you, Jesus. We magnify you, Lord. We rejoice knowing this day is for you, God. We lift you up, Lord Jesus. We Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, God. We worship you, God. We bless your name, Jesus. Lord, we just magnify you, God. You are so holy and worthy. Church, let's just worship God. Let's give him our hearts. Let's give him our mind. Let's give him our focus. Give him all that he owns, for he is worthy and he deserves it. He deserves every bit of us. Thank you.
some glory this morning. Amen. How many know that he's holy? He's righteous. He is worthy. Come on, just for a moment, let's clap our hands to the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Oh, magnify the Lord with me, the scripture says. Let us exalt his name together. Come on, can we just take a moment and exalt him in this place? Somebody just lift him up. We love you, Jesus. Face. I see a lot of faces I've never seen before. We're honored to have you at Spirit and Truth Worship Center this morning. If this is your first time with us, we say God bless you, and we are honored that you're in service with us this morning. Why don't you just step across the aisle, maybe find someone that you don't recognize, and just greet them in Jesus' name. Amen. So good to see everybody. Bless you this morning. You can find your seat today. As you return to your seat, just one more time, give God a great praise all over the room. Amen. Amen. Go ahead and find your seat all over the house, please. We're going to move right along with the service. Amen. You can be seated in the house of the Lord. Good to see everybody this morning. At this time, we've got a few announcements to make. I want you to give a listen to what's going on here at Spirit and Truth Worship Center. Mother is coming, also known as Tracy Moses. Let's give her a hand as she comes with the announcements.
Good morning. Isn't it great to have a place to come and get out of the world? I'm so thankful that we have this church and that we're a family. We are such a family. Somebody and I were talking just yesterday about what a family atmosphere we have here, and I'm just grateful for it. Ushers, y'all can come get ready to take up this morning's tithe and offering. And today's actually our building fund Sunday. We need a fellowship hall. We're fixing to have a couple of events this coming Wednesday night. We're going to gather here together for a Thanksgiving meal with our family. And that'll be a time where you see how badly we need a fellowship hall. So get your dishes ready. We'll have the drinks and the paper goods provided. Y'all bring the turkey and the dressing and the Cassandra pecan pie, maybe. just bring all that stuff, and we'll have a great time of fellowship on this coming Wednesday night. And also, we're going to need a fellowship hall for our New Year's Eve. We're not going to have one, but we need money so we can get one. Our New Year's Eve service, our watch night service, make plans, mark your calendars for that. More details will follow about that as well. We also need volunteers to go this coming Saturday to go out and feed the homeless. We're going to be taking a meal out to them. See Sister Denise, or there's a sign-up sheet out in the hallway. You can sign up if you can go help with that this coming Saturday. And at this time, you are released to bring your tithe and offering. Thank you.
Amen. We can start with the back rows. You can come and give of your tithe and offering this morning. Thank you for your giving today. Praise God. given this morning. Amen. Let's give God one more hand of praise. Thank you for your faithfulness to this church, to the house of God. Amen. God is so good. Somebody just say it as well. Amen. Janice, can you give me the key of C, I think? C. Lord, I just want to thank you. Is that what we usually do it in? See, I think that's right. Lord, I just want to thank you. 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 I want to thank you for being so good to me. So good to me. Sing it with me if you know it. Say, Lord, I just want to thank you. Well, Lord, I just want to thank you. Say, Lord, I just want to thank you. Oh, Lord, I just want to thank you. And I want to thank you for being so good to me. So good to me. Sing it with me. Come on, say, just wanna thank. Has he been good to you this morning? Lord, I just wanna thank you. Well, Lord, I just wanna thank you. Say, Lord, I just wanna thank you. And I wanna thank you for being so good to me. So good to me. Let's sing it one more time. Say, Lord, Lord, I just wanna thank you. To me. Let's take it to church. Come on, clap your hands. Come on, if he's been good to you this morning, you ought to just shout to the Lord. Come on with a shout of praise. Water when I was thirsty. You were my shelter in the middle of the storm. You were my friend when I was alone. And I want to thank you for being so good to me. So good to me. You were my bread. You were my bread when I was hungry. You were my water when I was thirsty. You were my shelter in the middle of the storm. You were my friend when I was alone. And I want to thank you for being so good to me. So good to me. Come on, one more time. Let's give it praise. Come on, break it down. Let's go. Somebody said, when I think of the goodness of Jesus and all he's done for me, somebody ought to just shout, hallelujah. Thank you. We might as well sing it one time. Come on, let's worship the Lord. And when of his goodness and what he's done for me, when I think of his goodness, how he died upon a tree, I can dance, 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 dance. Say, come on, sing it with me. Well, when I think of his goodness and what he's done for me, when I think of his goodness, how he died upon a tree, I can dance, dance, say, he's done for me. When I think of his goodness, how he died upon a tree, I can dance, dance, dance. Say, say all night, all night, all night, all night. I can dance, I can sing all night, all night. And when I think of his goodness and what he's done for me, when I think of his goodness, how he died upon a tree, I can dance, 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 dance. Come on, give him praise. Amen. Come on, bless the Lord, bless the Lord, bless the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen, 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 amen. We love you, Jesus. We love you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Our world's in a mess right now, but I believe there's still some praisers in America. I believe there's still the body of Christ expecting a revival to sweep across the land. Come on, anybody got a praise in this place this morning? Come on the count of three, from the bottom of your heart and the depth of your soul, I want you to just shout to God with a praise in this place. Are you ready? One, two, three. Somebody shout. Jesus. Praise the Lord. Amen. Praise God. Before you're seated, one more time, just give him a great praise. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. So wonderful. Amen. The Lord bless you this morning. You can be seated in the house of the Lord. Praise God. No matter what we ever have planned in the church service, we should never let what we have planned trump the praises of the living God. Amen. He's worthy of our praise this morning. Amen. So good to see every one of you at Spirit and Truth Worship Center, and God is so good. And I just keep looking at this crowd, and every time I look up, I'm like, wow, this is awesome. We just got a lot of people here this morning, and we're just honored to have you. And for those that have never been here before, I'm Pastor Travis Moses, and we're blessed to have you in the service with us today. And for those that have never been here before, this is the part of the service where I usually begin to preach, but as you can tell by our stage setup this morning, we're going to do something a little different today. And as all of you know, this past Friday, just 2 days ago, was a special day, Veterans Day, and turns out that we have about 8 veterans in this congregation alone. We've got one man that, amen. One man that served in World War II. Wow. We've got men in this congregation that every day of their life, they live with injuries that they suffered from making sacrifice for our freedom. I've spoke to veterans in this congregation that have had knee surgeries, shoulder problems, head injuries, and they received those injuries, leaving their families sacrificing for us, that we can come in here, praise God, on a Sunday morning like this, and we can enjoy the luxury of just praising God with freedom. And we owe these men so much. And before we get into this, I just want to say that what we're fixing to do this morning was not my idea. I don't want to take any credit for this. The men of valor approached me, Brother John Widener approached me a couple weeks ago and said, we want to do something special for our veterans. And I said, let's do it. It sounds awesome. And so real quick, I want to just read a scripture. It's found in Romans chapter 13 and verse 7. And here in just a moment, I'm going to turn the service over to Brother Minister DeMond Holly. We asked a few of our veterans if there was anything they wanted to share today, any stories they had, any testimonies they wanted to share. And I kind of was expecting maybe two or three of them to say yeah, and the rest of them maybe not to really want to speak in front of an audience. Turns out just about every one of them want to say something this morning. So we're going to let them speak today. We owe them that. And Romans chapter 13 and verse 7, the Apostle Paul simply said, "Render therefore to all their dues, tribute to whom tribute is due, custom to whom custom, fear to whom fear, and honor to whom honor." In other words, Paul said, you know, at all times, make sure that you give tribute to those who deserve it and that you give honor to those who deserve it. And the men that we are about to acknowledge today are worthy of honor this morning. So to all of our veterans, before I release this microphone, I salute you today and I thank you for your incredible service. And this service is for you, to honor you this morning. And so at this time, we've got a video presentation that we would like to show. And I'm going to turn your attention to the screens at this time. And the next voice that you will hear from is Minister DeMond Holly. God bless you.
No matter how long it may take us to overcome this premeditated invasion, the American people in their righteous might will win through to absolute victory.
In the long history of the world, only a few generations have been granted the role of defending freedom in its hour of maximum danger. Do not shrink from this responsibility. I welcome it. The energy, the faith, the devotion which we bring to this endeavor will light our country and all who serve it. And the glow from that fire can truly light the world. And so, my fellow Americans, ask not what your country can do for you, ask what you can do for your country.
Winston Churchill said the destiny of man is not measured by material computations. Forces are on the move in the world, we learn we're spirits, not animals. And he said there's something going on in time and space and beyond time and space, which, whether we like it or not, spells duty.
Praise the Lord, saints. Praise the Lord, saints. Family, it's good to be here this morning. And we welcome you again in the name of Jesus to this special day where we honor our veterans. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to this special service. And thank you for attending as we honor our veterans today. I'm honored to be speaking with you today on such an important occasion We're here to honor. Hallelujah. We're here to honor and our service members and to remember their sacrifices they have made and the courage it took to defend, hallelujah, honor and duty and country. The writer Michel de Montaigne once said, "Valor is stability, not of legs, not of arms, but of courage and the soul." We're here to honor our heroes, to remember their achievements, their courage, and their dedication, and to say thank you for their sacrifices. Thinking of the heroes who join us and those who are here only in spirit, a person can only help but feel awed at the enormity of what they encountered. We stand in the midst of patriots and families and friends of those who have nobly served. And I'd like to ask the service members and veterans to stand, please, all over the house. Service members and veterans, please stand. And I want to say thank you for answering the call to duty. Yes. You have made our armed forces the most respected in the world. Yes. Come on, let's give honor where honor is due. Come on. Give God thanks for these men and women that have taken the call of duty. We honor you, and we thank God for you. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. You may be seated. The service members we honor today came from all walks of life, but they share several fundamental qualities. They possess courage, pride, determination, selflessness, dedication to duty, and integrity, all the qualities needed to serve a cause larger than oneself. Many of them didn't ask to leave their homes to fight on distant battlefields. Many didn't even volunteer. They didn't even go to war because they loved to fight. They were called to be a part of something bigger than themselves. Selflessness. They were ordinary people who responded in extraordinary ways. In extreme times, they rose to the nation's call because they wanted to protect their country, us, hallelujah. Since the first shots at Lexington and Concord were fired, our Revolutionary War began. American men and women have been answering their nation's call to this day. Millions of Americans have fought and died in battlefields here and abroad to defend our freedoms and way of life. Hallelujah. Today, our troops continue to make the ultimate sacrifices. And even as we lose troops, more Americans step forward to say, "I'm ready to serve." They follow in the footsteps of generations of brave Americans. We have honored them with medals and many soldiers, and we have honored them with ribbons, our soldiers, and added their names on monuments and named buildings for them to honor them for their bravery. But nothing can ever replace the hole that is left in the hearts of those that have been fallen or that have fallen, these fallen service members. Hallelujah. And no number of medals, really, and ribbons or flags can comfort the ones that are left behind. People throughout the country will gather together to remember, to honor, to pay gratitude to those who have served our country. Our gathering is just one small spark in the flame of pride that burns across this nation. It's not a lot, but it's one small way we can honor those
who have made the ultimate sacrifice so that we can live in freedom. Your presence here and that of the people gathering all across America to pay tribute to those lost troops and to their families, it is a way to say we remember. From the soldiers who shivered and starved, hallelujah, starved through the winter at Valley Forge, to the doughboys crouched in the muddy trenches of France, to the platoon who patrolled the hazy jungle fields of Vietnam, to the young men and women who patrolled in the mountains of Afghanistan, we remember and we honor you. We will now honor our vets with a small token of our appreciation. First, I would like to call forth Danny Bundy. Give it up. Hallelujah. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. We honor you. Praise the Lord. Amen. Now I call forth EJ McCray. Would you please come forth?
From April 1998. 2005, Staff Sergeant McCray served in Operation Enduring Freedom, Saudi Arabia, Global War on Terrorism, Bomb Detection Unit, Support for Iraqi Freedom, Operation Southern Watch. Staff Sergeant McCray was awarded the following: National Defense Service Medal, Good Conduct Medal, Expeditionary Medal, Longevity Award, Leadership Award, NCO Professional Ribbon, Expert Marksmanship Medal, Expert and 20-plus Commander and First Sergeant Coins for exceptional performance. Thank you, EJ, for your service to our country.
Iraqi Freedom. Staff Sergeant was awarded the following: Air Force Training Ribbon, National Defense Service Medal, Longevity Service Award, Global War on Terrorism Service Medal, NCO Professional Military Education Ribbon, Meritorious Unit Award, Air Force Good Conduct Medal, Iraq Campaign Medal, Air Force Expeditionary Service Ribbon. Thank you, Oscar, for your service to our country.
Hallelujah. Yes.
Joel Clay Lane, Corporal E4, United States Marine Corps. Corporal Lane served from February 1991 through February 1995. Corporal Lane served with the Marine Security Forces at Polaris Missile Facility in Charleston, South Carolina, and with the 1st Battalion, 4th Marine Regiment, 1st Marine Division in Campin, California. Corporal Lane also served during the Somalian Civil War. Corporal Lane was awarded the following: Rifle Expert Badge 4 times, National Defense Service Medal, Southwest Asia Service Medal with 1 star, Armed Forces Expeditionary Medal, Somalia, Pistol Expert Badge, Good Conduct Medal, Sea Service Deployment Ribbon, Meritorious Mask, Letter of Appreciation. Thank you, Joel, for your service to our country.
Yes. Next, we'll call forth Mr. Emery Widener.
Emery Widener. Lance Corporal, United States Marine Corps. Lance Corporal Widener served from the year 1964 through 1967. Lance Corporal Widener served during the Vietnam War. Lance Corporal Widener was awarded the following: Combat Action Ribbon, Presidential Unit Citation, National Defense Medal, Armed Forces Expeditionary Medal, Republic of Vietnam Service Medal, Republic of Vietnam Meritorious Unit Citation with Gallantry Cross and Palm Leaf, Republic of Vietnam Meritorious Unit Citation with Civil Action Palm Leaf, Republic of Vietnam Campaign Medal, Rifle and Pistol Marksman. Thank you, Emery, for your service to our country.
Next, we call for Mr. Paul Rose. Please come forward.
Paul James Rose, Specialist E4, United States Army. Specialist Rose served from October 1965 through October 1968. Specialist Rose served during the Vietnam War. Specialist Rose was awarded the following: National Defense Service Medal, Vietnam Service Medal with 2 bronze stars, Republic of Vietnam Campaign Medal, Expert Rifle M14, 2 overseas bars. Thank you, Paul, for your service to our country.
Yes. So proud. Now we call forth Mr. Bill Cox.
Bill Cox, Chief Petty Officer E7, United States Navy. Chief Petty Officer Cox served from the year 1953 through 1973. Chief Petty Officer Cox served 1 tour in Korea, 1 tour in Japan, 2 tours in Vietnam. He operated in 37 different countries and joined SEAL Team 2 in 1961. Chief Petty Officer Cox was awarded the following: National Defense Service Medal, National Defense Service Medal and Bronze Star, Vietnam Service Medal. Thank you, Bill, for your service to our country.
Hallelujah. Now we call forth one more. Mr. Larry Moore, would you please come forward?
Larry Moore. Larry Moore, Corporal, United States Air Force. Corporal Moore served from August 1943 through March 1946. Corporal Moore served during World War II. Corporal Moore was part of the 1889 Engineer Aviation Battalion, 3rd Air Force. He was stationed in Hawaii, Guam, and Okinawa. Corporal Moore was awarded the following: the Asiatic Service Medal, Good Conduct Medal, 2 campaign stars for the invasion of Guam and Okinawa. Thank you, Larry, for your service to our country.
Yes. Hallelujah. Thank you. You all may be seated. Now, Pastor Travis has said that, and we've determined that they have a lot of things they have been through and have some things to say to us to encourage our hearts or just to let us know some experiences that they have had. And we're going to give attentive ear to. First, I'd like to call forth Mr. E.J. McCray to take his liberty. Give him a hand.
So I'll be pretty quick. We've been put on a time restraint. All right, so as I said, I started 1998, started 2005. I was initially supposed to go in on the buddy system with Oscar, but I guess Amber was more important, so. So what some people call us heroes, seamen, soldiers, airmen, jarheads, and more without understanding the true sacrifice. A hero is a person who, in the face of danger, combats adversity through impressive feats of ingenuity, bravery, and strength, often sacrificing his or her personal concerns for the greater good. Jesus Christ was the first real soldier that sacrificed it all. So what we did is we took the stand and continued to fight the good fight based on what Jesus Christ did. We would not be here if it wasn't for you being there in battle with us, you being there in war with us, during our peacetime missions, and when things were not so peaceful. So thanks for all those who, of course, fought the good fight, all of those who've been there with us. And for me, besides God, of course, being number one, I thank Ty for being there when I first got deployed. So with that being said, we just thank you all for being here with us, sharing this moment with us, and just appreciating everything that we've done. And I thank all of the soldiers and airmen and everyone who fought the fight with us, whether it was in the States or across seas or in the war. We just thank everyone. Love you. God bless.
Thank you, Mr. McCray. Now we call for Mr. Oscar White.
Praise the Lord, everybody. First of all, I just want to say it's an honor to be up here with some pretty distinguished gentlemen here. They did some real things here, and there's some history behind me, and I appreciate them. Just real briefly, 6 years, 2000-2006 in the Air Force. There was benefits that I enjoyed. There's things that I didn't enjoy about the military, but the good stuff outweighed the bad stuff. It set me up for the career that I'm in right now, which is air traffic. And, you know, I did, like I said, I enjoyed my time in the military for the most part. And like EJ said, got married to my wife there, and I'll be remiss if I didn't give true honor and appreciation to her, because the real service is what happens back home when, you know, we're out there. We're out there doing our jobs, you know, doing what we're supposed to be doing. Back home, somebody has to keep everything running smoothly, and a lot of times our spouses are forgotten in that, and the sacrifices, you know, that they put out for us. So I appreciate my wife and everything like that, and I thank the Lord for bringing me through. I went through probably a small portion of, it's a teeny speck of what some of these other guys behind me have dealt with, so the Lord blessed me through it all, and I'm appreciative of that. And just thank y'all for this. I think this is perfect timing with what's been going on in politics and everything like that. You know, the fact that the church is honoring this group here is diverse. There's a lot of backgrounds, a lot of races behind me and myself even, and everybody I'm sure comes from different walks, but everybody here is united right now, and you know. I think this is a good thing, and like I said, I thank the Lord for you all and for what you've done. We appreciate it, and you know, thank you for it.
Praise the Lord. I will call forth Mr. Joel Lane.
Well, first of all, I'd like to thank God for sparing me through all the things I've been through. And I'm, you know, the support of my family. You know, there's times I couldn't tell them where I was. I was just safe. And it's tough mentally, and it's tough physically. But I think God wants me to speak on one thing. We're off the coast of Somalia, I mean, like 60-some days. But early on that time, you know, our commander come and talk to us. He said, listen, you need to write a letter home. I'm like, write a letter home? We do all the time. He's like, the letter home. And that's when it got real. I know we watched, you know, Full Metal Jacket and things before. You know, we went in gun-ho, Rambo, all this stuff, you know. But let me tell you something. When it got real, everybody changed. Okay? But that letter, that was one of the hardest things for me to ever do. Because they would not release it unless something happened to you, to your family. But I just want you to keep in mind today, if you had to write your last letter, what would you say? If tomorrow may be your last day on earth, what would you do differently? I love my church family, and I appreciate you guys so much. I wasn't even supposed to be here today. I was supposed to be hunting in Ohio. But God has a way of making you, you know, come to where he wants you to be. I'll tell you that. And but I just want to leave that with you. Just think about it. And I appreciate you guys. I'm honored. Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
I feel the Holy Ghost. You ought to give him a praise break for rep. Hallelujah. What kind of letter would you write? Man, I think a couple of preachers got a sermon out of Now we call forth Mr. Emery Widener. Come on, son.
Well, I've got the mic. See, Travis is not going to preach much. I was going to say a couple of things, but I think I might say a few more. First of all, my mother was Japanese, and my father was in the U.S. Army in World War II. And after Japan was defeated, he had to stay there for almost a year and a half or so, the occupation. And they met, and I was born there in 46. So they came to Seattle in 47 and came on home. And then during the next all those years, they had 12 kids. And I was the oldest. And when I got my 17th birthday, I went to my mom and dad and asked if they would sign for me to go in service because you couldn't join on your own till you were 18. So my father, already been in war, was not, you know, and my mother after seeing what had happened. But I think we had at that time, I think there was 9 or 10 kids. I can't actually remember or something. Anyway, I know I went in 64, so I know Mary was born up after, but I can't remember if there was 2 or 3. So anyway, I told them, you know, there's not enough bedrooms, and I think we had like 3 bedrooms, you know, with 9 or 10 kids. So anyway, reluctantly, she signed. So in 64, I went to the Marine Corps. In 65, I went to Vietnam. Two things I'd like to mention about that. April, we had went to destroy what we thought was a Viet Cong stronghold up at Waterfall Mountain. Jets come in and bombed. We were in the river down the bank, and after all, they left. Then we started up the creek bed, up going up the hill. And then some our unit, my squad there, which consists of about 12 guys, and you have like 3 teams that are before. We had found some stuff on the left and behind some rocks, so 3 of the guys went there, and the corporal had me watch. I sat right in the middle of the creek on a rock, and I hadn't been there in a minute, and I just happened to turn around and look. And about 30, 40 yards down, I happened to see the enemy there, and he had actually had his rifle on the strap. And he saw me at the same time, and I just ran around and started shooting. Wasn't aiming at anybody up, just, you know, just, I was 18. And anyway, I guess he's still running, because I, You know, I shot, and he was as scared as I was, I guess. So, you know, he didn't fire back. He just took off running. And we went and tried to find, but you see his footprints where there was water, no blood or nothing. So he got away. And one other experience, this happened in October. And this was about 2:15 in the morning. And we got attacked by force. There was about 80 of us. And we got attacked by force from 300 to 400 Viet Cong. And we got overran. I had we had 16 Marines killed, 45 wounded. We buried 47 of them the next day. They probably got a big bulldozer, and that's just the way it is. A lot of those I had served with for a year and a half, was friends with, and hardest thing in the world. And so that was October. December 21st, I got to come home. I was home Christmas Eve of 65. And to this day, I saw action in between those two, but as I said, the first one was in April, the last was October. But to this day, I thank God so much for, you know, and I guess that first guy does too, because neither one of us, but both, I don't know, he might not have made it back home. I was fortunate enough to, and as I said, a lot of my friends didn't, but I do, and I thank God every day for my family. I got to come back and see my mom and dad, so I know who worried so much and watched TV so much after I went in. They didn't know that was going to happen when they signed the papers. But anyway, thank God so much for bringing me on. And I'll never forget it. Thank you.
Thank you. Amen. Amen. Mr. Paul Rose.
First off, I'd like to thank my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And to thank people like you for being behind us. Because if it was not for people like you, you lose your sanity. Because when a gun fires at you, there's a lot of difference in firing one back. It takes a strong man to withstand fire. I thank God each day for bringing me back. I remember a saying that Clint Eastwood made when he said, in a war, you lose a little bit of your body and your mind each day. I thank God for bringing me back. Thank God for the church that I decided to come to. I thank the pastor and his lovely wife for accepting me for just who I am. I thank each and every one of you. Love all of you.
Hallelujah. Now I'd like to call forth Mr. Bill Cox. All right.
Everybody recognizes it. Everything I did in life, I owe it to my parents. My dad was a preacher. My mother wasn't really a preacher's wife. She's the tough one. But thank God for her. In my Navy career, I didn't know God, but God knew me. I had 20 years of everything anybody told me I couldn't do, I tried to do it. But we all lose perspective what our country is, what we all fight for. This. Freedom. Do you know how it feels for me to see you burn it? I call on everybody, get back to normal. Normal is This is respect. This is freedom. Every one of these guys fought for this. You know I'm a man of many words, and sometimes people don't like the words I say. But trust me, every time I see somebody disgrace the flag, I want to beat the crap out of them. And why don't we get that attitude? That's not freedom or a right to destroy what mentally made us. That's about it. That's my sermon.
Thank you, Bill. Thank you for the words.
Okay, I will.
All right. Danny, do you want to say something? Come on.
I don't really feel well, but we'll make it through it. I don't know that I'll make it through it. It's hard when you fight for everybody that's out here and you sign that letter not knowing if you're going to make it home. And I just praise God that he made it because he has a plan for everybody that came home. I can't do it.
Praise him. Come on. Hallelujah. Come on. Oh, thank you. Oh, God, I thank you. Thank you for these men. Hallelujah. Last but not least, I'd like to call forth Mr. Larry Moore. You can sit down if you want. I mean, I'll hand you the mic.
There's a reason for everything. There's a reason I'm less. See, they know that I'm subject to get a disease at the mouth. Sometimes go beyond what I need to do or say. But I look around and I can't help but to think how blessed we are. Living in the greatest country on earth. And yet we are divided. And we think that we just come through a general election. And I'm not going to get into any of that, what happened and what is. But I will tell you this, of all the things that are happening out there, they're happening here, and especially in this country, we who know the Lord are most responsible. You don't have to agree with that. You don't have to agree with that. But God knows it's the truth. You see, it's what we are doing. Let me say this, and you may not like the sound of it, but judgment begins at the house of God. Why? Because you have met the Savior. We who claim Jesus as our Lord and Savior, we have met him. Anything that's happened in and around us, and if you don't speak up on it, if you don't speak up on it and you know it's wrong, then you agree with it. Because Jesus says, you're either for me or you're against me. There ain't nowhere in between that you can find a safe place, a safe harbor. You can't do that. So we got to shape up and start doing something. I really thank the men of valor. I really thank them for putting us together. So we men need to step up and be men. Be the men that God would have us to be. Because if we don't step up, things are going to just continue to go and be what they are today. If you don't like it, do something about it. I'm serious. If you don't like what's going on, do something about it. In the church, in your community, in your state, in the country, if you don't like it, do something about it. Start doing something about it. I mentioned to the men of Valley, you know, Pastor giving me one of those looks. But anyway, listen, I mentioned to the men of Valor that it would be a beautiful thing here if we had a school to go with the church. A school to go with the church. Now, I didn't get any report from them or anything about whether they thought it was good or whatever, you know. But I'm talking in front of the ladies now, and I know that make a difference. When you're in front of the ladies, I know it make a difference. So they got an ear to hear real good, know what's going on. So the thing of it is, so first thing, he said, well, where in the world are you going to get that kind of money from? Huh? Don't worry about that. Don't worry about the money. Pay attention to the dream, where you're going. Get the dream. Wouldn't it be beautiful if you had a school here? I tell you what you do. You start working on a school here, and everybody in the 10-mile radius will have children here. Don't worry about the money. I may not have it, but guess what? There are people in this country that got the money. Millions, multi-billions, and millions of dollars they give away every year. You know why they ain't giving us none? You ain't asked for it. That's why you haven't asked for it. Until you ask for it, you're not going to get any. That's just what it is and how it is. I'm going to get off that subject because I know I'll go too far. But listen, I want to tell you a little something. I want to share something with you here about when I was in the war. I'm going to go to when they dropped the bomb on Hiroshima to end World War II. Let me tell you something. I want to share this with you. Now, Okinawa's in where they dropped the bomb at is approximately 400 miles from where that bomb landed at. But we felt what was going on Okinawa. We were told what was going to happen. Let me just share this with you. I know some of you have read about that and all of this. But listen, we need to straighten up for more reason than one and realize that we're in a country that God has blessed to the fullest. But we don't want to ever see World War III, because it's not going to be what you think. We don't want nobody to start World War III, because you'll start a fire that you can't put out. Now that's what can happen if it ever starts up. You're going to have something that you can't put out. Now we better get smart in this country. We better get praying. If you don't know how to pray, you better start praying that we never get into anything like World War III, because it's not going to be like the old wars and things. I just wanted to share that with you. And I thank God for this church. I thank God for its pastor. I love you all. You are just loving people. And you just keep on loving, things will be all right. And you know, as a country, we need to learn as a country too, one other thing, that you can't change the world. Best thing to do is don't mess with other people's stuff. Because if you want to get along with them, don't mess with other people's stuff. You learned that when you were children growing up. It goes for countries and everybody else. Just leave people alone. They'll straighten out this thing. Leave them alone. If you can help them, you do that. But just leave them alone. They'll help themselves. I want to thank you. I want to thank all these gentlemen here that we served in a time that they served in their time, I served in my time. Things are different from what it was when I was coming along. But anyway, may God bless you, may He keep you, and may you remember that we're in the greatest land on the planet.
Thank you so much, man.
Yes, stand to your feet. Again, let's honor these men, those fallen and those that are. Hallelujah. Now I want to call Pastor of this great body, Pastor Travis Moses. Give him a hand as he comes. Come on, this is our own. Come on. Come on, this is our own. Hallelujah. Lift up. The man of God, the under-shepherd, feeds our soul with the word of God. Thank God for him. Hallelujah. Thank God. Hallelujah.
Amen. Let's give God a great praise. I think that was awesome. Amen. What would your letter say? I might preach that next Sunday. I don't know. I'm going to get with Joel, see if he's got any more notes for me. But amen. Let's give these veterans one more round of applause this morning. Amen. I tell you what, I think it would just be fitting this morning. I know this has been different, but, you know, different is good. And these men are worthy of honor today. And I think it'd be appropriate to just close the service like this. I just want to ask these men to just come down, if they can, and just stand, line up in front of this table, if you would. And as we dismiss this morning, why don't you just, before you leave, come down to the front and shake their hand this morning and thank them for their service. This day is about them, and we honor them today. Amen. Let's give them one more hand clap of appreciation. Let's close in a word of prayer. Just bow your heads with me. Father, we thank you, Lord, for this great nation. God, I thank you for every word that these veterans have spoke to us today. I thank you, God, for sparing them. I thank you for your mercy over their life, God, and we just thank you for the freedom that we all have, and we give you praise and we give you glory. And Father, we just pray right now that you would bless this nation at this pivotal time, God. I just pray that you would unite us, God, that you would give strength in the name of Jesus. And Father, I pray that you would use the church, use the body of Christ, God, to bring revival to America. God, in Jesus' name, as your word declares, judgment starts with the house of God. Let us take hold of our responsibilities, Lord, and what you've called us to do, and help us change the world. In Jesus' name, amen. I want to thank one more time the men of valor for this awesome presentation. Brother DeMond Holly, Brother John Widener, thank you guys so much. Amen. Before you leave today, just come down and shake these guys' hands, and you're dismissed in Jesus' name. Don't forget Wednesday night, 7 o'clock, be back. Bring a covered dish. We're going to have a Thanksgiving meal together. Amen. Amen. And if we could just get a few men who maybe would just hang out for about 5 minutes.